already sewing, or do you want to learn? Welcome to Power Sewing.
Hi, I'm Ron Collins.
Welcome to Power Sewing. I'm Sandra Vitzina.
Today I want to talk about all the men's patterns out there. Well, at least the really, really good ones. Now, Sandra, I am very envious of all the women's patterns because you ladies have so much to choose from.
That's true.
You know, if you look at the big pattern books, they're probably 1,000 or 1,200 pages, and there might be three little pages dedicated to us guy sewers. So I'm going to show you my favorite patterns out there. Now, the first one is made by Berta, and this is Berta 8452. I'm actually wearing this jacket here. The only major alteration I did with this one is I made it an inch and a half shorter. I just found it was too long. But this is a great pattern, the 8452. And then I did it in this pleather, and then I had to do it again in another pleather because I loved it so much. This is more of a stress pleather. And it's fully lined with a rayon Bemberg lining. I used a YLI top stitching thread, a spun polyester.
And when you use that, use a regular thread on the bottom.
That's right, and the heavier thread on top. So that's a real good jacket. And you can see that I did it in these synthetic leathers. But let's look at another view, view B, which is done with a collar. And this is just out of a polyester gabardine, not an expensive fabric of any means. But you can see that the different view, you get a totally different look. These are from the same pattern. And it's different fabric, different details. This one is very simple. It's all unlined. And, you know, I love putting these.
You can see it doesn't wrinkle, which is fabulous.
So this stuff is good. Well, all these fabrics don't wrinkle to me. So that's a great jacket, the casual jacket. Another pattern that I love is the new mode 222132, and it has the pants and the vest. So let's take a look at that. I've done these in a linen, and here's the pants, and what I've done with these,
isn't it? Yeah,
I underline them with silk organza to cut down on the creasing. And then with the vest, it's completely underlined with silk organza to cut down on the creasing.
And you always pre-wash your linen first, don't
Just to soften them up, and it just cuts down on the creasing as well.
I agree.
So that's another great casual outfit. That's that new mode pattern. And let's just flip it over. There's a little detail with the pockets.
Oh, it's great. It's a great pattern. Yes.
Okay.
And I like the drawstring.
A great shirt pattern is 7767. I tell you, if you want a classy shirt, which is timeless, get this pattern. This is the best fitting pattern out there. Here it is in a classic striped fabric. Timeless, but, you know, very sharp looking.
Oh,
now with
nice.
This view here, or with this pattern here, you have actually three different views to do the collar. The big thing right now for men when it comes to collars is the spread collar. And here's the same pattern, but what I've done here is I've used contrasting fabric for
the cuffs and the vent,
the sleeve placket, the collar band. There it is there.
Oh, it's nice.
Just to change it up. And then I did a button-down collar as well.
Very nice. That is a nice pattern.
Sandra and I have done some DVDs on jeans, but this here's a new jean pattern, which I really like. It's a quick sew.
For guys, 3504.
Cool. Now, quick sew probably has the best selection of men's patterns.
I agree.
At least they've dedicated, you know, I'd say at least 20 pages.
They have more. Yeah. So you like Berta a lot, but
I like Berta.
They're good. They're very good.
Quick sew does fit nice for men as well. So here's the jeans done on just some basic 12-ounce denim. And then let's take this pair too. Let's not move that one. And I'll just show you how I change things by putting in different seams just to change it up
and
little details.
So, you know, the idea is you go to the store and see the little details that they're putting on clothes, and then you
and
come
then
back
you
and put them on yours.
See, I'd have to have, you think about it, how many women's patterns out there? Lots. So I have to make do with what I have. And let's take a look. Same pattern, but totally two different looks. By just changing the design details on the back of the pockets and zippers, eyelets, all this hardware stuff. I sound like Santa Claus walking down the street with all this stuff, but it's fun. Great.
All right.
Here's another casual shirt pattern. This is Berta 7811. And I'll show you the actual view A. This is view A, which has the sides are cut in a knit.
And it has a t-shirt. It's all connected.
It's all connected. The sleeves are, there's a short sleeve out of the woven and then the long sleeve out of the knit. And what's unique about this, it has a front, side front, and then it has a back and a side back panel. But nice. So I fell in love with that pattern, and then I thought, you know what, I'm going to change it up a bit. So I did it again in linen. Let's just hang on to that for a sec.
All right.
And you can see that I did the side panels in all woven fabric.
Oh, it's all the same.
So it's all the same.
Nice.
So you
and you eliminated the sleeve.
I got rid of that knit sleeve.
Okay.
And, you know, by just changing, for example, the closures, here we have snaps and here we have the buttons and, you know, different pockets and whatnot. So, same pattern, different look.
When you find a good pattern,
stick
make
with it.
I know.
This here is the Berta magazine. It's put out by Berta, of course, but this comes out every month. It's always loaded with tons of women's wear. And occasionally, twice a year, they'll squeeze in some men's patterns.
Oh.
Usually I'm guaranteed the month of April and the month of August that there'll be some men's pattern. So I always rush out, and this is the jacket I did. This is a great jacket.
Nice.
And here it is, and it's in a stretch poplin, unlined, and you see it looks a dent. I was able to find the same fabric, can you believe it?
So the issue here is
April of 06. And I think, Sandra, we have to do a show on working with these Berta patterns because these are a little bit different than the ones you find in the envelope. So that's one jacket.
Oh, nice.
And what I've done, I did it in linen and I completely underlined it with silver cams. You can tell I must have been bored that day with all these detail.
Oh, but look how great they look.
But this here cuts, you know, the linen, as you know, creases, and then the silk organza cuts down on the creasing. Well, I hope this inspired you to sew for the man in your life, and I think this was great to show these patterns, because there's not a lot out there, Sandra?
And you know, you could take some of these details from men's patterns and put them on women's patterns.
There we go.
We'll see you next time. Now, today we want to show you a notion that we both love called Simflex. And it's very cool. It's this little device like this, and it expands. And Ron's going to show you how to use it for buttonholes. But tell him the other thing, where you used to use this notion.
At one time when I was a chef and in cooking school, we used this for cake decorating and scoring cakes as well.
So you'd score it on the top, and then if you went around the sides, you'd bend
it. Actually, to go around the cake, you did this. You know, if you were going to do a basket weave on the side of a cake, so your basket weave wouldn't get all crazy. But anyways, I don't decorate too many cakes anymore. I just sew shirts. So what we're going to do here is, let's actually do, like, for example, placing them buttons, right?
Okay.
If you make your buttonholes, or you sew on your buttons, what you do is, this will expand this, and I'm going to open it right up. And you can see what I've done is you've marked every place for a button. And you can do the same thing.
And you know, the other thing is if you have an extra button, pinch it up. Do you
if
see?
You find these are too far, you can
just bring it up closer.
Bring it up and you can do this. You can use one, skip one, use one, skip one. Not bad. And you can also use it for marking tucks and pleats.
Pleats, I was going to say.
I know some knitters use this as for like knitting gauge as well.
Yeah, this is a very cool notion. Now, I usually make my buttonholes first, and then I sew the buttons.
That's right.
Okay. So what do you think?
About what?
Power sewing.